What is up, everybody? Welcome to this week's Jesse Spec YouTube video. This one, I have been personally waiting for it for a really long time. Today you will see how I put the 2ZZ physically into the MR2 chassis, and there's no point about talking anymore about it. Let's just dive right into the video. Join me now. Okay, welcome back to the warehouse. Today we're gonna be getting into something that I have been wanting to do for a very long time, and is to drop that engine into the MR2 chassis. So you can see that in one of my previous episodes, I actually destroyed the front cover. It was the alternator bracket that broke off. I actually replaced that, had to reset the whole timing chain and everything. So once I got all that done, I bolted the transmission back onto the engine. Just for the little side note, since my clutch hadn't come in yet, I put the stock flywheel of the 2ZZ in just to make sure to be able to crank the engine. So there is no clutch inside at the moment. I did this because we have a simple problem with this power plant, is that out of the four brackets holding the power plant into the engine, three of them are actually held by the transmission, on the transmission. So, for example, the big gray subframe that you see here is connected to the transmission. That's one. You have one on top of the gearbox and one behind the engine that is also fixed towards the gearbox. And you actually have only one bracket on the right, that is the one with the swap bracket, that is actually fixed to the engine. All the rest is connected to the transmission. So you imagine, I could have thought, okay, let's just put the engine in like that and I will take care of the transmission later. The big problem with that is that I actually can probably not really fit the engine in without fixing or mocking up the gearbox to it. So this is why I did this. So like that, you can see a little bit my way of installing the engine. So as you can see, it takes a lot of fiddling and checking and adjusting the engine to get it perfectly in. As you can see in the video here, I didn't realize it yet when I was doing it, but the engine is not sitting perfectly flat. It's slightly tilted on the left. Okay, I had to take out the swap bracket for the new...
Yeah, hold in my...
I had to take it out just so it's easier to put in on this side, because as you can imagine, if you're going down with the car like this, this is pretty likely to hit somewhere, so I just took it out before.
Okay, so at this point, I'm going to be putting the bracket back onto the engine first. So there are like four screws to do that. I decided to tighten them just slightly so I can actually wiggle the engine or the bracket around a little bit to get all the holes to align. And this, you will see, is not that easy, because I actually, even leaving a lot of slack into the screws, I have to move around the engine a lot. I could have edited out this whole part of me moving the engine around, but I just want to show you that this is actually the hardest part of this swap, is to get everything to align perfectly. And it all comes down to one bolt on the right.
Now, we're gonna put this bolt into the engine mount so we can screw everything together.
Or so I hoped. Because you can see that I still need to move around a lot of things and pull the engine around, still not being able to align everything. This is really a little bit the annoying part. And you can see that my green cart there, I really love that thing. It actually holds 500 kilos and it's supposed to be sort of like a rolling toolbox. But this thing is amazing. Like every time I have engine removals or transmission removals, I use this thing because it moves around very easily, as you can see. And this helps really to get things to align perfectly. So at this point, I still didn't manage to get the bolt in. And now I realized that I had to maybe go down with the body of the car a little bit further. And at this point, I managed to get the screw in. Finally, I got that bolt in, so now I'll be able to go on the other side and start getting the upper transmission mount bolted in. Okay, so we see that on the engine mount side, I still have two bolts to screw in, but we see that on the chassis side and the engine side, everything is aligned. And now I need to take care of the other side, which is on top of the transmission mount, as you can see here. To make the whole power plant hold into the chassis, I still have four bolts from the subframe that I have to bolt in. As you can see on this big gray part, this is the subframe. And here you see one of the transmission mounts bolted to it. By the way, I didn't mention this, but I highly recommend you follow the step-by-step way I'm installing this, because this is the easiest way to do it. So now we're going to be focusing on the second bracket on our to-do list to get the engine to hold in the MR2 chassis. And that will be the one on the far left that is on top of the transmission. What I like to do is I like to use a jack stand, and in this case, a piece of wood that I'll be jacking under the transmission to push it up and actually push it into the bracket on the body side. And as you see now, I'm inserting the screw because it holds with one long screw. So that's what I'm doing right now. And usually what works well is to wiggle the whole thing around. So as you can see here, I'm moving the jack stand a little bit. And by moving the jack stand backwards and forward, like I'm doing here, this will help you to insert the screw easier, and it will hold the whole thing into the car. Yeah. Now let's get under the car, bolt in the four main screws to hold the subframe in, and we'll be able to lift the car up. The engine is in the bay. After this big victory, I had to keep moving with the good spirits. So I decided to hook up the aircon hoses that you see underneath here. This always amazes me. So we have a totally different engine in the car, but we could reuse the stock 1ZZ air conditioning, and the hoses bolt straight back into the chassis of the MR2, which would give me a functioning air conditioning. This is a race car, so it's not really gonna be useful, but to be honest, I was a bit lazy and I just wanted to keep the same accessory belt that I had before, so I just decided to go with that. It's well possible that I might delete it in the future. So here you see I'm just tightening a few bolts here and there just to make sure everything holds, and I'm getting on with the whole reassembly. This part is really annoying. So we have two of these hoses, cooling hoses, that are connecting the body where the radiator is in front to the engine. There is really no place hardly for your hands in there, so getting the hoses and the clamps back on was really a pain. And actually the second one, I just decided to skip it because I was getting very angry. Okay, we're making progress. As you can see, the injection rail is installed from the 1ZZ, so the MR2 version is installed with the 2ZZ injectors. I installed also the swap bracket, as you can see, with all its screws necessary in order to install it correctly. As you can see here, I have everything installed here. I have still a few cables to take care of. And here we have the loom, basically, that I'll be passing in a few minutes through that hole back over there. I don't know if you can see it. There. That hole over there. So I'm going to pull the loom through, and we'll be cleaning up here, tightening up the last things
And who knows, engine might start really soon. Okay, we've made more progress, as you can see over there. The loom went through the firewall here. Now we'll be putting the battery tray back and we'll be able to start the engine really soon. I'll just put the intake on as well. Oh, the accelerator cable also was installed, as you can see here.
The accelerator cable has a really bad nick in it, so I'm gonna have to figure out something else. But for starting the engine, I'll just leave it like that for the moment. It will be addressed later because, of course, this is not sustainable.
And okay, so now install the ECU. As you can see, plugged in all of them in here like this. So just gonna leave this for the moment because anyway I'm gonna be starting the engine with the stock ECU just to see if everything runs. And then from there, we'll put the power FC and start tuning.
Okay, everything is back together. Wow, look how close the 6-speed passes next to the firewall there. As you can see, it's a very tight fit, but it still looks like it was meant to happen. So I'm really happy with all this. Here you can see everything is reinstalled, new oil filter. The gearbox cables will be hooked up later. Once I finished the work I have to do with the clutch. And here I'm just showing you a little bit around the engine, how everything is fixed together. I am so happy that everything managed to get into the car and it's holding in place perfectly. Now, let's get started and fill in some fluids. Let's start with the engine port. There are various recommendations regarding engine oil. On my behalf, I decided to go with the, what I had available. So it was a full bottle of 10W40 racing synthetic oil by Minerva Racing. I know that many use 5W30, but to be honest, this will be just fine to get the engine started and do some running in of all the components that I changed. So now I'm just checking the level, making sure everything is okay. And after filling up everything, we're good to go.
So as you can see here, I pulled out all the injector plugs so I don't have gasoline going into the cylinders while I'll be making the oil pressure go up. So next step will be putting the oil pressure up. Once that's done, let the gasoline run through the whole system. And then we can try to give it a start. Okay, so I put the injector plugs back in and let's see if the engine starts.
I know you guys are gonna hate me for this, but the first start will be in the next episode.
Thanks to all of you for hanging out until the end of the video. As you see,
victory, we have
the 2ZZ in the MR2. I showed you a quick brief noise of what it does just by firing it up slightly just in order to get the oil pressure stable. So in any case, next week we'll be starting up the engine for real now, filling up the coolant And anyway, this is a big step in this whole build, because that's always the apprehension of everybody, is how difficult is it actually to put it into the car? And in the end, it was pretty straightforward. And in any case, I appreciate you guys for watching the videos, subscribing each time. It's growing and growing, and I'm really having more and more fun to make these videos, especially since things are getting more and more interesting. In any case, the holidays are coming up, so make sure to enjoy this season, and I'll see you next week.
Thanks for watching this week's episode. I hope you liked it. If you did, make sure to smash the like button. If you haven't subscribed as well, make sure to do so, because next week we are firing up the engine. It's official, no joke. Thanks for watching, and see you next week.